They're the two greatest, most influential shows and characters of all time. The cigar-smoking lieutenant of Columbo and the cigar-smoking mob boss of The Sopranos. On the surface, the two have little in common. One is a relatively cozy armchair mystery program, while the other is a brutal crime drama about the American mafia. But if you dig deep, and that's what we're all about here, baby, you'll find some interesting connections. Today on Echoes of Columbo, we look at the top Columbo-Sopranos crossovers. Let's start with Richard Kiley, appearing as Deputy Police Commissioner Mark Halperin in the Season 3 finale, A Friend Indeed.
You just lost your badge, my friend.
Perhaps his greatest success was in musical theater. In The Sopranos Season 4 episode, Eloise, Paulie Walnuts reminisces about a trip to Broadway with his mother.
Remember we saw a man from La Mancha that time? Richard Kiley, stand up, Ma. The whole time he was singing The Impossible Dream.
How I cried.
Interestingly, in that episode, Paulie smothers an elderly lady while searching her home for cash, echoing Halperin's drowning of his wife for her inheritance, yes. Director, actor, and producer Jack Bender made a brief yet pivotal appearance as a delivery boy in Publisher Parish, helping to convict Riley Greenleaf in Jack Cassidy's second Columbo appearance. But did you know that he also directed 4 episodes of The Sopranos? Season 3's Another Toothpick.
I had to help him off the toilet, he's so weak.
Will you shut the up with the toilets?
And To Save Us All from Satan's Power.
The boss and his family told you you're gonna be Santa Claus. You're Santa Claus.
Season 4's The Wait.
We don't work for drug dealers.
No.
Of course not.
No.
And Season 6's Mayhem.
Please, let me take that from you. Looks like it weighs a ton.
I don't want to.
Well, you need to.
I don't believe any of those episodes feature a delivery boy. Stuart J. Zully is most notable to Columbo fans for being the third man to portray the inscrutable Sergeant Burke.
Got a minute, Lieutenant?
As well as a few other police officials. See my previous video for more on that. But he also has a recurring role on The Sopranos. Almost unrecognizable after the passage of a decade, Zully appears twice as Allen Ginsberg, Tony Soprano's family accountant. His real family, not the crime family. In Season 4's Pie Oh My, his financial advice provides an early point of contention between Tony and Carmela.
What a kid said there was tremendous tax advantages.
To Carmela, when you die.
And in Season 5's All Happy Families, he appears at Feach LaManna's card game.
We did it.
This naturally leads us to Robert Loggia. Am I pronouncing that right? He gets a supremely juicy role in The Sopranos' 5th season, where he plays elderly but vicious gangster Feach LaManna.
That time on. Nobody so much as looks at me cross-eyed!
Loggia also appears in Columbo Season 5 episode Now You See Him, playing Cabaret of Magic owner Harry Blanford. Appearing in only a handful of forgettable scenes, he's almost criminally underused.
I'm sorry, I'm a pest, but I'm very confused.
Yeah, you're looking.
Simmons, get a wine list over to table 31 right away.
Bruce Kirby is a true Columbo institution, rightly beloved for playing the lieutenant's most oft-appearing sidekick, Sergeant Kramer, from the 70s through the 90s. He was also a lab attendant, a TV repairman, and a different sergeant named Brindle, who was, in all other respects, identical to Kramer.
Can we go now?
Sergeant. Now watch The Sopranos Season 5 episode Marco Polo, and you'll recognize Kirby as Dr. Russ Fagoli, an old buddy of Carmela's father, Hugh. His character, a retired diplomat, leads Tony to utter one of my favorite lines.
So you're a doctor like, Kissinger's a doctor.
Just like his Columbo character, he's shown to be something of a humorless jerk.
Yes.
Huh. I saved the biggest, literally, for last. He's the only man to have appeared on Columbo while he was acting on The Sopranos. Conjuring up ominous memories of strange bedfellows, Stephen R. Sharippa appears as the mob-affiliated Freddy in the series finale, Columbo Likes the Nightlife. The episode's air date in 2003 lands right between seasons 4 and 5 of The Sopranos, where he played the much-put-upon but lovable Bobby Bacala.
Richie?
Pay attention, you just may learn something here.
Sharippa holds the additional distinction of receiving Columbo's last ever spoken line, as well as being the last character to share the screen with the lieutenant.
Oh, well, that's very nice. I really appreciate that.
Yeah. Think I got them all? Has anyone noticed any more? If not, I guess that just about wraps it.
Yeah.
I'm in awe of you.